Hello friends, welcome back to a new session. And in this session we are going to discuss about the troubleshootings for electrode coating process, means CED process. CED means cathode electrode deposition process. So before starting the session, I would like to thank you for your appreciation and for your dedication towards me. So this is Avatar here, and let's begin the topic. So what is electro coating? So actually electro coating, you know, electro coating, it provides a decorative and protective finish, and common coating defects may adversely affect the properties. So we know that electro coating provides a decorating and protective finish, and it's very eco-friendly and less labor required to complete this process, and very productive coatings for any automobile sector. But because of some troubleshootings, there could be some common defects that can adversely affect these properties. So it is important that electrocoats users develop basic effective troubleshooting skills. Means they should know about the troubleshooting skills. Means if any tackle is there, means any issue is there, so how can we tackle that issue? How can we just resolve that issue if we are getting any issue any time? So let's start. Let's know about those troubleshooting methods or skills. So before talking about the how can we troubleshooting any problem, so what is a troubleshooting process? So it is important to understand troubleshooting in order to develop sound, workable solutions and problems. There are five stages of troubleshooting. So continue with the five stages. How can we identify troubleshooting? So first one step is this. We have to define the problem. So how can we define the problem? So you know that defining the problem is the first step of troubleshooting process. Means this is the first step through which you can define the problem, and it characterizes the problem by answering several questions. So first one is isolation. Means is the problem in the operation of the system or appearance related? Means the problem which is occurring in an operation or of the system, it is related to appearance. Then second one is identification. Means what type of defects is occurring, and does it occur on all parts? Means it's coming on all parts, or it's coming continue, or it's a defect is coming on several parts. Means randomly you are getting that defect or what? So you have to identify that. Then third one is a location. Does the problem move around on the part, or it always in the same area? Means the problem which is coming on a component, it's coming on a same location, same part or same area, or it's all around the part. Means somewhere it's coming on front or sometime back. So it's like that, or it's coming on a particular area. So you have to identify the location as well. Then fourth one is timing. So when did the problem start? Means problem start kab hua tha? When it started? So we have to find out that. Then what is the duration? Means is it constant or sporadic? Means it is a constant problem. Means you are getting it from earlier, or it begins before some time, or before 1 week, or before one day. So you have to know about that. Means what is the cycle of that troubleshooting. Then second one is identify the root cause. So identify the root cause. It's a possible root cause is step two in the troubleshooting process. Means it is second step to identify the possible root cause for the troubleshooting process, and it is necessary to understand common causes to the defects. Means if there are any common causes, how can we just know, understand the process defects or any cause, then there could be several path variables could be there or any process areas investigate. Means like if any like path parameters or they are not in spec or any kind of like investigation, means we can do for that. Then commonly asked questions include the following, like is there any correlation between the both, means what are the common cause for the type of defect, and have there been any recent changes made to the line. Means like if you are not getting a DFT, right, CED DFT, so it means is there it is related to solids, your rectifier voltage, what temperature and what S content and pH and all, and your and electrolyte, means those are working, means anode shields are working properly or not. So it is there any correlation between the defect and the process. Then so if you are getting any relation regarding to that, so you can just identify that problem very easily. And there could be two kind of relation, mechanical and procedure. Like what is a mechanical? Is the testing equipment functioning properly? Means that could be one cause. Means whatever like testings you are doing with the mechanical equipment, those are working properly or not. Means like if you are checking the DFT, dry film thickness, with the elcometer gauge, means that DFT meter, so is this working properly or not, calibrated or not, so and battery is working properly or not. And if you are checking solids, so your like bearing balance is okay or whatever like formula you took is right, or whatever oven temperature you set for the to check solids are okay or not. So these can impact on that problem as well. Then procedure means have the testing procedures been followed. Means whatever like testing procedures or SOPs have allowed to do for the particular test, so you are following the procedures to perform that test, or to doing testing, or you are just doing randomly without any SOPs. Means SOPs like a standard operation procedure. So according to that you are doing, or you are just following your own method. So that even also could impact on your it could be also a root cause for that troubleshooting. Continue with the troubleshooting. So this is the step third, determine corrective action. So determining the appropriate corrective action is the next step in the troubleshooting process. This step is probably the most time consuming. We know that it takes more time, because to determine and for a corrective action it takes more time, and developing a logical plan that tests one variable at a time is crucial to identify potential solutions as well, and asking the following questions should help develop a practical action plans. Means if you are like following variable questions, first one, like which variable can be tested on the line quickly. Like if you are getting any defects and variable is there, so which variables you can just check or test quickly. So first you have to categorize like that. Then second one is which variable can be tested with tighter disruption to production. Means disruption with production. Means then you have to find out in corrective actions that is there any variable that won't be impact on a production or productivity, but you can just check immediately and you can work on that. Then third one, corrective actions you can take like Which variable can be tested online in the paint lab? Means if you are having a paint lab in your paint shop, so is there any like test or action you can take for as a corrective actions, and it can be do with itself in your paint shop. And the fourth one, you can just go which variables need technical support from the suppliers. Means if you are getting a paint like for example from Nerolac or Asian, so is there any like corrective actions you can take, and you can just ask for the supplier that this kind of defects we are getting in our process, how can we tackle this problem, or how can we just take a corrective actions for this. So these are four steps you have to keep in mind before taking a corrective actions. It should not be impact on productivity, means production. Then it should be a quick process. It should be related to mostly in your paint lab, and you can ask for that to your suppliers from where you are getting your like paint. Then fourth one is implement corrective actions. So this is like implementing corrective actions, the success step in the troubleshooting process. So it looks like something, we got a corrective action, now we have to implement in our process, right? So it's a really a happy stage to do something, implementation of our process, to control the issue what we are getting right now. And so as each variable is tested, and it will either be eliminated or identified as possible solution. Means a lot of tested we do, and identified that it's a possible solution for this. So there may be multiple solutions, and in rare cases there may be no solutions. So for that, to implement that corrective actions, there would be multiple solutions, or there, by chance there could be not any kind of solutions. So in that case, where no solutions have been found, it is necessary. Means if you are not getting in a proper solutions to identify, means to resolve the issue, then it is necessary to start the troubleshooting process again by redefining the problem. Means before implementing the corrective action, you have to think that this is the solution, means this is the perfect solution to prevent this defect or troubleshooting. If it is not a perfect solution, then you have to refining your process, and you have to think more about the defect and about the issue, how can we just resolve that particular issue by with the team, with the help of team, and by just submit your opinion on a particular problem. Then best thing is you can work with a team, and teamwork really will give you different kind of opinions from different kind of people, and really you would be able to resolve the issue. Then five stages is a follow-up. So you know that follow-up is the last step in the troubleshooting process, and it involves determining what permanent changes are needed to prevent the problem from recurring. Means if you are getting the problem, then how can we just take a follow-up for that? And if we have a solution, and how can we just changes do in our process, or which kind of changes needed in our process to prevent the particular problem which is occurring? So actually this troubleshooting models provides guidance for identifying, detecting, and solving problems. So there could be a problem, means follow-up, like there could be a problem related to your both tank, means CED tank, related to your oven, and related to your different kind of things like rectifier, then rinsing or pre-treatment line. So on that you can think. And about the follow-up, means how preventive actions methods, we will be discussing in the next video. So just wait for a next video, in that we will be discussing about the follow-up stages, means like preventive actions methods. you are getting a particular defect from this stage, and you have to work on that stage. Means it's coming from a water tank, means ED tank, oven, rinsing, pretreatment. So we can identify like that, and it's related to your raw material, means your whatever, like stainless steel or whatever components are there, it's related to your supplier. So these things we can identify because of to do a good job with a follow-up, to take a proper follow-up. So for that we will discuss about the preventing action methods in the next video. So till the time, thank you, and I hope that you would like this session, and if you like, please share with your friends as well. So thank you guys.